I welcome you all on this 44th convocation of AIIMS on 3rd December 2016. We also have completed our Diamond Jubilee year on 25th September 2016 and will be releasing a commemorative stamp. An Honorable Minister of Communication is here to help us in doing that. I welcome all the three dignitaries, our Honorable Home Minister Shri Rajnath Singh Ji, our President Shri Jagat Prakash Nadda Ji, and Shri Manoj Sinha Ji. Very first outset, I would like to congratulate all the awardees during 44th convocation of All India Institute of Medical Sciences. I also take this opportunity to express my acknowledgement for all my colleagues, the AIIMS family who have stood with me in through thick and thin and contributing immensely towards the growth and development of the institution. Sir, All India Institute of Medical Sciences has been entrusted with trinity of mission, that is medical education, research, and above all patient care, both preventive and curative. And digitization is the means with which we can achieve all these three very, very effectively. If we look at the education, we have a strong undergraduate program, and we have, I am happy to share with you that we have increased the intake of undergraduate students from next year to 107 from 77. We have also almost doubled the strength of our postgraduate and super specialty courses. During this convocation, 693 precisely, the students will receive their degrees, and about 400 of them are present here in various disciplines. AIIMS has always stood for excellence in medicine, in research, in patient care, and has been judged in various independent surveys year after year as number one institution. In education, we have been doing the two-way tele-video conferencing between AIIMS and other institutions in the country and Africa. I take pride in telling you that we have been able to start 27 new academic courses in recent past. This would not have been possible without untiring efforts for my team led by Dean Academics, the former Dean Professor Jhulka, and the current Dean Professor Balram Aaron, Associate Dean Dr. Bansal, and Registrar Dr. Sanjeev Lalwani. I would like to, ladies and gentlemen, give them a big round of applause to all of them. This has been a remarkable year through where we also started some MD programs, MDS programs, MSCs and BSCs. For the first time in the country and in this part of the world, we developed and evolved the concept of fellowships, and I am happy to share with you, sir, that we are beginning to start 32 fellowship programs in various sub-disciplines of various centers and departments across AIIMS. I'm also happy to share with you that over last 3 years, we have been able to increase the strength of AIIMS faculty from 493 to 737, almost 50% increase in the strength of faculty. The fellowships, of course, is the new programs, so 100% increase. DMN and MCH courses, almost 150% increase. And senior residents, which provides the backbone of the service of this institution, 35% increase. The postgraduate courses, 25% increase, and the MBBS, 38% increase. We also received number of overseas and national short-term and long-term trainees, WHO, and others. Over last 1 year, because of the Diamond Jubilee celebrations, every department was more than enthusiastic to organize some workshop, some conference, some CME, and I am happy to share with you that this is a record that over last 1 year, we organized almost 200 conferences, workshops, and various kinds of courses. The faculty, residents, and staff development has been very proactively pursued by our Center for Medical Education and Technology and Innovation during the current year. The research, of course, is the backbone of this institution. And over the years, the extramural grants have increased. And I'm happy to share with you that the current year, we had 72, almost 73 crores of extramural funding, ongoing 618 research projects, and they were funded by various national and international agencies across the globe. The intramural projects were on almost 150 with almost 5 crores support from the institute. And we published almost 2,200 articles and 308 book chapters by our distinguished faculty, sir. I'm also very pleased that research publications, the AIIMS is at the top. And if you look at in the country and even globally, if you see, we rank third after MGH, Massachusetts General Hospital, USA, Mayo Clinic. Then we come and the China is behind us in this. We have had a lot of research initiatives in the form of research methodology courses for our faculty, scientists and residents. And I'm also happy to share with you, with your, sir, in the governing body, we approved the AIIMS Endowment Fund, and we already have Infosys chair, where Professor Dean Brenner, who has just arrived last night, and he is with us in the morning in this auditorium. And a lot of residents and PhD students have benefited through this endowment fund, and we hope that this will work very effectively towards pursuing research at All India Institute of Medical Sciences. We have also in the process of establishing centralized core research facility. New initiatives include research methodology courses for faculty and postgraduates, innovation facilitation division, new patent and technology transfer policy. School of International Biodesign is doing extremely well. Some of the national programs and policies influenced by research done at AIIMS have led to national programs devised by the Ministry of Health, Government of India. We have 7 WHO collaborating centers in various departments. Following the visit of Honorable Prime Minister to Japan, we are pursuing very closely collaborative projects with Osaka University, Tottori University, Osaka City University. AIIMS and University of Michigan collaboration is going strength to strength, and we have had a lot of faculty going there, their faculty coming here, and that is working very, very effectively for us. Recently, sir, with your permission, a delegation from AIIMS faculty led by me visited France, where on the invitation of French Academy of Medicine, where we signed MOUs in the field of cardiology, infectious diseases and cancer. The AIIMS has been judged as the oasis of India's poorest. Year after year, AIIMS has been the best brand hospital from India. And we actually see almost 3.5 million patients in our outpatients. We admit more than 200,000 patients and perform 150,000 major procedures across all departments and centers. The RP Center, which is the Center for Eye Diseases, has been doing extremely well in various, providing various services, including corneal transplantation and also using stem cell for the regeneration of cornea. Cardiothoracic Center and Neuroscience Center has been leading the way forward for the country. And I am very proud of sharing with you, sir, and all of you, that AIIMS did the 50th cardiac transplant this year. And it has been a remarkable year for us that we were able to perform 13 cardiac transplants in one single year. And this is one of the patients dancing after the cardiac transplant. I congratulate Professor Balram Aaron for that. Neurosciences Center is one of the best, or I would say the best center in the country and this part of the world, and we can have parallel from anywhere in the globe. Newer technology and at affordable cost, we are working towards, and we are giving routine service in gamma knife for brain disorders, robotic assisted surgery by Department of Urology, by radiotherapy, modern techniques, and in diagnosis also. The therapy, we want to develop nanotechnology. We had recently held a conference, regenerative medicine and molecular and genetics diagnosis. As I mentioned, during the current visit to France by the delegation from IRCH, we signed a MOU with the newly built hospital in Toulouse in France which is a cancer hospital, latest state-of-the-art hospital. Center for Dental Education and Research has been a landmark in signing collaboration with Cochrane, WHO Collaborating Center for Oral Health, and also Ministry of Health, Government of India has recognized it as a nodal center. Our rural center in Ballabgarh has been doing extremely well, looking after the population there. Trauma center has been working very closely with Australia-India Trauma System Collaboration for trauma system development in the country. Sir, with the success story of digitization of trauma center, when I took over as director of AIIMS, this was a huge challenge for me, how to digitize AIIMS itself. And it has become a reality, as you also are aware of that. And digitization of AIIMS has been a remarkable journey for all of us, where our mission is to provide affordable health care for everyone in the country, not compromising the quality of care. The quality improvement program, I am happy to share with you, has gone very strong with us, and Professor Ashok Devrari is leading this program, and he has built teams to lead this quality improvement program, which is an essential component of any institution of this size or even a smaller institution. We are serving the poorest of the country. The IT implementation naturally requires the design, build, test, and train, and transition that for the benefit of masses at large. The milestones in digitization have been, in January 2015, we worked with NICN, the unique identity, the Uday, and with their help, we even connected Aadhaar for online registration. Then we signed an MOU with TCS, who are doing great work for us as CSR. And in July 15, the online registration system was launched by Honorable Prime Minister in Digital India Week. And on 25th December, sir, your good self actually launched the project AIIMS OPD Transformation Project, the first digital revolution in healthcare by yourself, sir. And e-hospital project has been completed, and India's first fully digital hospital, I'm very happy to share with you. I'm very proud of that. We have done extremely well in e-hospital modules, operational at AIIMS with registration and appointment mode, registration and appointment module, various modes of taking appointment. And if we look at, the benefits are immense, and there has been 100 to 300% increase in online registration and digital technology after demonetization, which has been a very encouraging news for us. This is the AIIMS dashboard looks like. Admission, transfer, and discharge modules are in place. E-laboratory module, billing, dietary services, laundry, kiosk application in 200 kiosks across the hospital. Online donations has been a huge hit with our adopt a patient policy. Radiology packs is also in place, and I must say radiology information system, laboratory module, and drug library with third-party integration has been achieved. Innovative IT using in-house programs has also led to eMLCs, which has been very much liked by the court, sir. You are the Home Minister, sir. This has been liked by Delhi courts, that at least they can read the reports what doctors are writing. Otherwise, they were illegible reports. The National Death Registry of India has been digitized. The challenges remain. Challenges has been the change management, which is always difficult for the institution of this size. Hardware procurement issues always remain in the government sector. Manpower issues, they always remain. Software issues, very slow turnaround time for changes, change request, and bug fixing. So that has, there is a new space for academics action, cohort study. Conference hall has been renovated. The cafeteria, a new cafeteria will be launched very soon, I think in early next new year. For OT, there was a demand for a cafeteria for a long time, we could do that. Our library has been fully digitized. Examination section from the inception of institute never had its own space, and we were able to provide that space where they do a remarkable job. Please give a big round of applause for examination section under Dr. Siddharth Datta Gupta, Dr. Ashok Jarial. Sir, this is the Center for Integrative Medicine you inaugurated. The epilepsy lab has been shifted to Convergence Block. Surgical block is near completion. We hope to launch it in next 3-4 months. New hostels in Masjid Mohd would be ready soon. We hope that our engineering section is working overtime to have these projects completed. Trauma center expansion has been completed. We are awaiting completion certificate from NDMC. There's a new ICU and private ward block at trauma center. Power Grid Vishram Sadan with the donation from Power Grid Corporation of almost rupees 29 crores to build this Dharamshala. And now, sir, long pending our aspiration to have a helipad on the top of this Dharamshala. It was supposed to be on the top of trauma center. This is a unique cadaver training research facility which has been used extensively by all specialties, set up by Dr. Sumit Sinha, from Professor of Neurosurgery. We have the simulation facility at trauma center.
Started ATLS provider courses precisely on 16th April 2009, and over last 6 years we have conducted this is the 200th course. We have also expanded our sites.
We also got land adjacent to trauma center for upcoming new centers, which, sir, you have very kindly lended all support which was required for this project. So I wanted to show you the tunnel, but apparently these glitches have, I checked it before starting, but we are not opening, so I'll move forward. Sir, we have received, our digitization team has received a lot of awards and accolades besides the Prime Minister appreciating it. We were awarded for fully digital hospital by the Ministry of Electronics. We have this pavilion we set up at Pragati Maidan with the support of Ministry of Health recently, which was appreciated widely. So I would say that takeaway messages from digitization of AIIMS is that it is possible. We need champions to pursue it, perseverance and ownership in all areas. Change is a process, it's not an event. And here I must thank the teams from NIC, the NIS and TCS. So I'll take you run through the projects which have been completed. The underground tunnel, it is working now. So this tunnel is awaiting opening, and I would request, sir, that we request the Honorable Prime Minister to open this tunnel. It's a very dream project. It's a 35 crore project, and it has been an engineering marvel by the DMRC that it is going between the metro and the road. And they had a lot of challenges while building this tunnel across Aurobindo Mark. And this takes to Safdarjung Hospital, it takes to trauma center. NCI work is going on with full speed. We have surgical block, as I mentioned, will be commissioned. Cafeteria will be commissioned soon. New hostel complex, we hope that the things would be very quickly done with. Mother and child construction, sir. This is one area which I would like to flag, that this is oversight committee and the funding has been an issue, so the work has been slowed down. So I would request your intervention for the provision of funds so that the work on mother and child block and surgical block can be speeded up. The new OPD block, the work is on. The paid ward block, again, this is one black spot in the whole process of modernization, that we had basically the contractor ran away, the previous contractor, and we are now in the process of awarding this, so the work is still incomplete. The vertical expansion of trauma center has been completed. The Vishram Sadan has been completed. You have very kindly got the cabinet approval for the redevelopment of West Campus and Sarinagar and Ayurvigyan Nagar for building almost 4,000 dwelling units for our faculty and other staff, which is aspiring to have that for a long time. Development of trauma center expansion is on, and we are in the process of submitting the EFC. We have also got approval for a teaching and integrative medicine block, because this auditorium falls short of the demand. When we have the convocation, we cannot allow the parents to come in, so that work will start. Future at AIIMS, the increasing indoor bed capacity to almost 6,000 in next 5 to 7 years, pushing the frontiers for developing regenerative medicine and nanomedicine, next generation genomic sequencing to be established at AIIMS, and we would like to see other developments. Jai Hind, thank you.